What is going on YouTube and y'all squad? This is your boy Yocrates, and this is your review for The Real Housewives of New Jersey season 12 episode 13. So this is the season finale. Right quick, what happened was it was supposed to record on DVR. Somebody decided to cancel what I had recording to record what they were recording, and I totally forgot that the very next day Peacock actually has it on Peacock. So I could have done it last week. I didn't. So yeah. So you're getting this now. Hopefully you'll get the reunion part one later on today. So just want to put that out there. Also, if you guys missed the Whether You Like It or Not panel that, you know, the season premiere last night, don't go there now. Like after this review, go over there and watch it on Scarlet by Nature TV's channel. We had a good time. We gagged. We roasted each other. We were shady. People got some brand new nicknames and whatnot. It was a great time had by y'all. So with that being said, let's get into this review. I will say I think we're going to be here for a little bit because there are some points that I want to expound on. There are going to be some things I gloss over, I guess, to compensate more for time for more important stuff. So D'Lo hired a chef for breakfast. Great. These are things that I like to see where, okay, if you're not going to actively be in the kitchen cooking breakfast, have some, like, hire a chef to do it, especially when y'all are going to be out having drinks and all that other stuff. The couple talks amongst themselves about last night. Jackie, we find out she still hasn't fully committed to her therapy, where she's trying, but she's missing steps, and that happens. Is no different than people who are on a weight loss journey where, you know, you might start off strong with maybe like the first day or two and then it gets difficult. So it's a yo-yo effect. But she says she's going to try today. Melissa calls Teresa and Teresa wants Melissa to check Marge. And I can appreciate because, look, I lost a lot of love for Melissa these last two seasons, especially this season. But she said to her, both of y'all are grown. Y'all can talk this out, and I appreciate that. Where it's just like, stop putting me in it. You grown, she grown, y'all handle that. Good stuff. So at the table, Mars checks Joe about giving his sister pretty much a gold star, a participation trophy. Now, I have my own ish with my siblings and whatnot, and for the most part, I can talk mess about my sibling. You just can't. Now, depending on where the relationship is, and he's in a good relationship with his sister, it should have been one of those where I hear what you're saying, and I may have my opinions about my sister's actions and whatnot, but trust and believe, that is a conversation that we have behind closed doors. Just like you don't reveal what goes on between you and your husband, even though this sibling right here, I'm not going to discuss what goes on between me and my sibling, but behind closed doors, I take care of what needs to be taken care of. I do feel that Joe should have a little bit more, like he should stand up for his sister just a little bit more, just a little bit. But anyway, Jen brings up the whole Jackie accepting the BS apology Teresa gave her last year. And she said, well, I did that because she's like, well, Jackie accepted this apology. And in essence, we knew that was BS. So, you know, Marge, why can't you accept the apology that you were given, even though that apology was not directed at her? It was directed at the table. And Jackie's like, I did it last year because I was afraid of what else she would do in regards to my family. And then Melissa said, if there's nothing there, then what do you have to be afraid of? She was like, I understand that now and I'm good on her. But here's something that y'all got to pay attention to. Back when they did the trust building competition, trust building exercise. And we found out before, but it was addressed then about Teresa still digging after things were squashed. And Teresa said, because you said something about my daughter. So in essence, Jackie was right, where it's just like, yeah, it was just best to let it go because what could come, you know, after that? And come to find out, you're still digging to have some ammunition, which I get it, you know. Let me see. No. I said that. So then Marge brings up the fat shaming. Like, okay, I was fat shamed. We're not even going to talk about the other times, but last night at the table, I was fat shamed. And they were like, oh, well, you know, we don't stand for that. And she's like, but none of y'all said anything. So it's one thing to not be here for it, but if you don't address it in the moment, if you don't, and again, for some of them who have these deep ties to Teresa, like her brother, Dolores and Frank, that might not be a conversation you have at the table in front of other people, but might be a conversation you have with her behind the scenes, or not, well, away from the group. It's like, you know, that wasn't cool, right? But none of that is happening. And Dolores says, we're not her parents. You don't have to be somebody's parents, because what Marsh was saying is bad behavior is displayed. When you don't hold someone accountable in their minds, it's okay, I can continue to do what I just did, because either A, I'm being praised for, or B, I'm not being reprimanded, so I must be right in what I'm doing. And a lot of the times, and I'm actually currently dealing with this, to where people expect the weaker of the two, or one they feel that they can, you know, move to change actions. So in my case with me, I'm, you know, younger than most of my relatives and whatnot. So of course it's like, oh, well, you just need to change. But it's like, but you're not telling this person to change their behavior, which means that if I just be the bigger person, which being the bigger person doesn't serve me, well, I'm literally doing what y'all are doing, telling this other person that your actions and your behavior, you are justified in it, which means that you can continue to do it, continue to hurt me, and I just have to accept it. Bull. That is what Marge is trying to communicate. I don't think that they're picking it up. And on some real stuff, if the girls really wanted to, and by the girls I say Melissa, Jackie, and Marge, if they really wanted to, I'm looking at the screen right now to make sure I'm not missing anybody. They could really sit here and run this show if they really, really wanted to. Just saying. But hey, whatever. Not here to give anybody any ideas. So there's a bike ride where, you know, they're pedaling, but they're being served drinks. Then there's a drink game. Every time they hit a red light, you take a drink. Y'all know I like to drink. Like, if I ever go to Nashville, especially with a group of friends, I want to do that. I really, really do. Like, that seemed so fun. So they get to a restaurant. The men want to do a competition because they have some very high chicken there. So we'll revisit that. Teresa decides that in this moment, she wants to talk to Marge. Now, remember, they just got finished drinking. So now they're in this public place. She decides that I want to have this conversation with Marge right now. Now, everybody, for the most part, the majority of the table is just like, no. How about we wait? We just got done drinking. Can we have one moment together where it does not spiral out of control? Like, now is not the perfect time. Teresa wants to do it right now because this is what she wants to do, because again, she's the queen of the show. So if I want to have this conversation right now, we're going to have this conversation right now. If I tell you to stop talking about Louis, you're going to stop talking about Louis. There's a trend here. Marge doesn't feel this is the right time, because it wasn't. And at the same exact time, it's the energy that came before the interaction. Because you want to talk, but your energy is saying you're coming to be very confrontational. You're coming because I'm here to check you rather than present this information so you have a better understanding of why I feel the way that I feel. I want you to understand me in this situation rather than I'm here to check you. So Teresa wants to do it right now, and Joe pretty much gets her to be like, no, we're not doing this. And if I was Marge, because Marge gave her too much, because she was trying... I would have been like, I'm not doing this right now. And I would have just sat there. Paige, you complete dust. Because once I say I'm not doing so, I don't care about all this other stuff. Like, unless you want to sit here and put hands on me, you just going to sit there. Because I already told you I'm not doing this. And you're not going to make me do anything. I don't care if the cameras are here. I just want to get paid for that scene. So Jen asks Marge if she appreciated the gesture that, you know, Teresa's trying to make this work. I am about, now look. I still plan on doing a video about why I feel they were trying to ice Jen out. But okay, Jen, you look, you got too much brown on your nose. Okay, like I'm gonna need for you to really, really stop. Even Dolores isn't doing this, and that is Dolores' job, to stay on this damn show. And Marge is like, it's always on her terms, which it is. And then Marge says, I forgive quickly. And she alludes to, you know, how Teresa encouraged Danielle to pull her hair. Now, again, not to sit here and defend the action. had Danielle just did it on her own, I ain't got a problem with it. Because again, at the same exact time, you threw drinks on this woman and you pushed her soon to be husband, who is now her ex-husband, in the pool because you got upset. So had Danielle did that just because she wanted to do it and decided to do it, one thing. But to have it encouraged by somebody else, like, yeah, go do it, nah, not cool. But she says, I forgive quickly, and it's to my detriment. I'm not going to do it this time. And of course, when it comes to apologies and whatnot, the best apology is change behavior. And here's something else that people need to remember and understand. Just because you forgive somebody don't mean you got to mess with them. Like, I can forgive you for what you did and all of that stuff, but because you've already shown me you, that's cool. We can coexist. I ain't got to mess with you like that. That's what some people be forgetting. And not going down that road today, y'all. All right, continuing on. So we finally get the competition, and let me see. I know Tiki wasn't there. Evan didn't participate. I think there was one other person. Never mind. So all the men, you know, decide to eat this hot chicken, and I was so upset because Joe wanted an abundance of this chicken, and you've already been told that it's very hot. Now Bill is accustomed to eating very spicy food, so technically he won, but Joe is just like, oh, we could just call it quits, it's a tie. So all that food went to waste. Granted, they paid for it, but still, all that food went to waste. And for what? So they get back to the house, don't care about that. Now we're at the very end, the rooftop dinner. So Jackie asks Marge if she'll talk to Teresa. Which, this is one of those where, since y'all do this, y'all really do make this the Teresa show, nevertheless. Marge kind of like, I don't know. And then Jen vouches for Teresa yet again and says, like, you know, like, she's making efforts. Like, you know, those little things that, you know, you give kids for participate. And they look like, we're not giving her a participation trophy. And Jackie said, I already got 4 kids that I got to treat like kids. I'm not going to treat an adult like one. And they pretty much talk about, in essence, lowering their standards, you know, to, you know, do for Teresa. And again, what tends to happen is when people do this and they excuse bad behavior, you are letting that person know that you are complicit in their BS, and again, not holding them accountable. So Teresa finally arrives. Louis pulls Joe to the side and, you know, thanks him for, you know, being genuine with him, and asks for his sister hand. I'm sorry, will ask for his blessing to marry his sister, seeing as to how obviously their parents are divorced, so he's the closest male. And Joe is just like, you know, I liked you when I first met you, then all this other stuff came out. I chose to not get, like, engage you because, again, the last time I did that with my sister's ex-husband, things went badly. But in order for me to give you this blessing, hey, bro, what happened in the past? Like, just let me know. And Louis just says that he was married, got divorced, had some messed up relationships after that, and, you know, he made mistakes, but he's tried to get better. And hold on, wait. Oh, and also, I also forgot to mention, because I'm like, I know he said it. He also says that he needs her. That right there is kind of iffy. You need her for what? Okay. So he gets the blessing. Teresa says when they're, so Teresa is talking with Melissa. And Melissa's just trying to, like, get this thing to, because she's like, Margaret really isn't trashing you the way that you think she is. And you're sitting here and you're wilding out. And then Teresa says, you know, when there's bad energy like that, in essence, she hulks out. This is one of those things where she's semi-taking accountability, where it's just like you're acknowledging the fact that, you know, you rage out, but at the same exact time, rather than just saying all this happened and I just chose to let it, like, to give into it, it's, oh, there's bad energy, so this brought it out of me. Like, you're not fully accepting responsibility and you're shifting the blame to somebody else, saying that your actions caused me to lose control over myself and then become this, you know, individual. Whatever. So Teresa and Marsh talk, and Teresa says, if you had concern, you should have talked to me from the very beginning. And Marsh like, I did do that at your pool party. I did do that. And I also told you to get ahead of it. Were those her exact words? No, but that is literally what she was saying. Like, Louis should just come out and say something, because here's the reality. Granted, other stuff did come out, but had Louis just, and did Louis have to? No, he didn't. But this is reality television. We know how this thing goes, and they should, because they've been on this show for how many seasons? But get ahead of it. So once that happens, there's nothing left to talk about, which means that once Marsha Jen made up, she wouldn't have had a storyline for the remainder of the season, right? Right. And then she even says, when I first met you, I spilled all of my tea so nobody else could. I told you that I cheated on my husband. I married a contractor, blah, 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 blah. I told y'all all of this. Which, when she did it, nobody could really say anything because she owned up to it. And if somebody does say something, she'd easily be like, yeah, and I told y'all about that. Now what's next? Right? So, Teresa gets teary-eyed because she feels that now there is, you know, light in her life. That, like, this flame, you know, has been rekindled. And, you know, there's sunshine. There's positiveness because, you know, she got hit with all of this fraud stuff. You know, she got arrested, well, put in prison. Her then husband got put in prison. He got deported. They had to divorce, you know, and having to pick up the pieces of this, even though you did play your part. So for her, it's just like, I now have some sense of joy. And it seems like y'all are trying to snuff this light out. I can appreciate Marge not even giving in, even, and I felt that this was a real moment Teresa was having, but Marge, she don't be caring about the tears, y'all. And Marge lets her know, like, well, from the jump, you weren't being transparent. Like, I hear what you're saying, but it's hard pretty much to, like, have compassion for you when this was brought to you. Oh, I don't know nothing about this, when you did know. So, and then Teresa felt like Marge wasn't sincere in her delivery and wants to be dealt with kid gloves, because she was like, well, when my mother, you know, had passed and everything, like, the way you came and how sincere you were. So she pretty much wants, when somebody to come to her, that you need to sit here and be all meek and everything and then present it to you on a silver platter. And my thing is, if you're friends with somebody, yeah, you know, you need to read the room, and sometimes you have to, you know, deal lightly with somebody, but sometimes you just need to come on out and just say what the hell it is that needs to be said. And this wasn't even an attack. This was her literally, and we all agree, she was trying to tell her, like, he needs to get in front of this. And it didn't happen. So whatever. So you have the girls talking, and Jackie had pretty much said, like, Marge did nothing wrong. Marge actually is the one that vocalized everything that we were saying behind her back. I'm like, and that should have been said to Teresa. So Teresa says that, you know, Jen and D'Lo, they know me and they know what sets me off, pretty much saying, like, they know not to do these things. And again, yeah, when you're friends with somebody, you do know what triggers them and whatnot. But at the same exact time, when certain things need to be said, they need to be said. And if you want to sit here and throw the friendship away because I'm holding you accountable and I'm letting you know some stuff, regardless of how you like my delivery, if that is enough for this to dissolve, cool, fine, so be it. But again, Teresa wants minions. Marge says that the women have lowered their standards for her. And Teresa was taken aback by it. And Marge, So Marge lets her know, like, you have done so wrong by me. And she didn't even go to previous seasons. She just ran down the laundry list of this season. Because you saying you here for me, you done did this and this and call me this and this and this and this. And Teresa was like, well, you know, hold on, wait. I want to make sure that I don't miss anything. Right, so then Teresa was like, yeah, because I'm mad, or because I was mad. Okay, that is taking accountability. Yeah, I said all these things because I was mad. Got it. But Teresa still isn't trying to sit here and offer any form of apology, because she's not sorry. And my thing is, I don't like people that apologize when they know they don't mean it. And I don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't do that. I don't like people that accept apologies when they know they really don't accept the apology. And of course, Joe Bonino and Louie comes over, things get a little bit escalated, and then Marge is like, you know what? I'm done. I'm not doing this anymore. I am done. So then Louie says thank you and good night to Marge. Now, here's the thing, bro. I got it that you sitting here defending your girlfriend. You weren't even in the damn conversation. And that right there is some very messed up stuff. And even though it does not require any confrontation, Joe Bonino, I understand you're an older gentleman. You should have checked the hell out of him. Just be like, hey, bro, don't even talk to my wife, bro. Don't talk to my wife. Like, this was between them. It's done. But that right there is some very passive aggressive. Anyway, this is when I was just like, your slip is showing, Louis. One thing that I've always said, and I learned this when I was in the military, is in general, but I'm speaking from when I really discovered this in the military, is that we all wear a mask. Even those that are very transparent, we all have a mask that we wear. And this is how we show up and we appear in the world. But what happens is you really get to know a person when pressure is applied. And when you get to see the cracks in the mask, because that's when glimpses of that person seep out. It's only during those real heavy, heavy times. Y'all know what I'm trying to say, damn. And then Louis says to Teresa, she's making you work too hard for an apology. Teresa wanted to have this conversation, not Marge. But okay. And then Margaret is, and then he says, Marge is starving to sit in your seat. So now what you're doing is you're playing to her ego. And now we're starting to see that behind the scenes, you're actually sitting here and you're putting batteries in her back. Because you want to sit here and be like, oh my gosh, like, why did you freak out? Like, when she pretty much pushed all that stuff onto Margaret. But now we're starting to see that, no, behind the scenes, you're sitting here being a little bit of a puppet master. And then Louis says, you know what? We should get a jet and get out of here. Okay, now we're starting to grandstand. Now we're starting to sit here and be like, oh, we got this type of... Because here's the thing. She could have just said, like, you know what, baby, we can just get on the plane and go. Oh, no, you had to specifically say jet. Mm-hmm. And then he said, I work hard and you'll never have to work another day in your life. Isn't that lucky? Do you? And if that's the case, then you could have kept her off this season. Y'all could have quit mid-season when all this stuff really started to come out. So now you make enough money. Uh-huh. See, again, there's something real shifty about it. And look, if y'all really catch it, early in the season, Louis was all peace, love, rainbows, unicorns, and pixie dust. Now is, we got this. And then was like, let's move into our 15,000 square foot house. So again, we literally started to see the ego behind Louis. And it seems like this is more the true him. And the way all of that came out, there was an aggressive tone to it, which could lead to some of the accusations being right. Now, is he physically abusive? I don't know. But I can see a mental abuse. Even when he said, if I don't do this, how will she ever learn? And I'm going to end with Margaret said, I was right about Siggy. I was right about Danielle. And I'll be right about Louie. And that's where it ends. I'm not going to recount what the women got going on. We don't care. Some of it's probably going to come up during the reunion. But yeah, that was the season finale. It felt like it was cut short. But I will say, for the most part, New Jersey pretty much was very clear and concise with what they gave us. Like the last couple of seasons, they've been cutting up the fluff out and it literally just giving us, you know, the meat and potatoes, even though last season ended abruptly and that was weird. But again, this was a decent season. So hopefully you guys enjoy the review. Y'all let me know, do y'all think I'm spot on when it comes to Louis? And yeah, I will see you all for the reunion part one. Peace.